Hello. Morning, my friends. How are you? It's almost a month, I think 22nd of March 2020, since we are all locked up, locked down, and arrested at home, doing nothing, getting bored. And it's a very sad situation. I think after the earth is born, humanity came into existence. I think this is the first time that a man who is supposed to be or born to be a social animal is forced to stay inside his own house, not even stepping out to see how the world is. So definitely we're all getting bored. So I thought, let me indulge, involve, and bring you all into a common platform where we intellectually interact with each other. So in the process, one interesting proposition which I recently faced in one of the cases that I filed, I thought I would discuss about it. Just an intellectual, academic interaction. Nothing beyond that. For God's sake, don't misunderstand me. It's only an interaction. Let us try to understand the little principles which we generally tend to ignore. So the case is like this. There is a contract with steel plant, and the contract naturally contemplates resolution of disputes by way of arbitration. And the arbitration clause has two divisions. Two aspects of that clause. The disputes which are arbitrable. For example, the contract contemplates the scope of the work is construction of, say, a building, an administrative building of steel plant. Say about 1,000,000 square feet of construction in 10 floors. With certain specifications, and the value of the contract, say, is about 50 crores. Okay, let's not go by the exact values, about 50 crores. And the time frame is 3 years. So, from the date of the contract, within 3 years, you are expected to complete the construction and deliver the building to the chairman managing director of the steel plant. RINL, Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, which owns, runs Visakhapatnam steel plant. So the contract is concluded and the work began. And during the course of construction, there were certain delays. The site is not properly handed over. There are certain obstructions in the site. There were certain pipelines underground. Unless those pipes are removed, you cannot proceed with the construction. You cannot proceed with the piling work, whatever. So there are certain delays which are solely attributable to steel plant. And the work which is supposed to be completed within 3 years, extended beyond 3 years, say by about 2 more years. So the total work took about 5 years for you to complete. But the contract contemplates 3 years only. The delay is understandably attributed to steel plant. And then in the meanwhile, out of this 50 crores contract value, of the which is 50 crores, you rose your bills, you have been sending your REA bills, steel plant paid, about say 38 crores and 12 crores is balance. Now you have various other claims, not only this 12 crores, which is due and payable by steel plant, being the balance amount due. You also have a claim for the delay. Mr. Steel Plant, because of the delay on your part, I had to incur additional expenditure. I had to maintain this office for 2 extra years. I had to maintain the staff. I had to pay for the labor. I had to pay for the equipment. And on this account, I had to incur an additional expenditure or a loss, damages, to a tune of say 25 crores. Further, you did not pay me the amounts for the works done as and when I did submit my bills. You delayed the payments. Because of that, I am entitled to interest also. The interest component saved is about 5 crores. Okay. So the total claim that you have is 12 crores being the amount due for the work done as per the terms of the contract. Claim number one. Number two, 25 crores being the interest component for the, I'm sorry, 25 crores towards the damages for the delay. And then 5 crores being the interest component. So your total claim consisting is 12 crores plus 25 crores plus 5 crores. In 3 claims, claim number A, B and C, the total amount due is 25 plus 5, 30, 30 plus 12, 42 crores. So you did send a notice to steel plant asking steel plant to pay Mr. CMDRINL, you pay me 42 crores on these heads. And the steel plant will naturally send a reply denying, disputing the claims, saying that Mr. X, you are not entitled to any claims. And now you have the dispute resolution mechanism which is incorporated in the contract. The mechanism is naturally arbitration. So the arbitration clause, say clause number 17 or 18 or 20, whatever. This clause says any dispute between the parties with regard to the principal sum due alone is arbitrable, and all other claims relating to interest, claims relating to liquidated damages, etc., are beyond the scope of arbitration. They are all excluded or accepted from the scope of arbitration. Now, interestingly, your claim is consisting of, claim of for 42 crores is consisting of the principal sum of 12 crores plus 25 crores being the damages and 5 crores being the interest. Now your doubt is, where should I go? For example, if you invoke the arbitration clause and take this claim to the arbitrator, steel plant will definitely file its counter saying that, Mr. Arbitrator, claims number 2 and 3 beyond your scope, you cannot adjudicate these claims. Therefore, dump them into the dustbin. You are entitled to these claims, but unfortunately the contract prohibits the arbitrator from adjudicating the claims, because contract number, clause number 17B says, Mr. Arbitrator, you cannot deal with these claims. So, though you are legitimately entitled to these amounts, the arbitrator, in view of the contractual injunction, is prohibited from adjudicating those claims. It is not that you are not entitled to it, but it is the arbitrator is not entitled to adjudicate it. Okay. Now, what will you do? You are advised to go to the civil court. So, you will file a civil suit depending upon the claim, because the claim amount is about 42 crores, you will naturally go to the commercial court. You will file a civil suit there. In that suit, steel plant will file its, definitely, an application under Section 8, saying that, Your Honor, may kindly read clause number 17. Clause number 17 contemplates resolution of the disputes between the parties by way of arbitration. Therefore, this suit is not maintainable. So, act as per the procedure contemplated in Section 8. So, in that application, naturally, you will file your counter. What would be your counter? Your counter says, yes, Your Honor, there is an arbitration clause, but my claims B and C are excepted from the scope of arbitration. The arbitrator is not competent to adjudicate these claims, claims number 1 and 2, or B and C, that is damages and interest. Therefore, my options are limited, or the only option I have is come before your court. Now the question before the court is, can I decide all the claims? Claim number 1, 2, 3. Claim number 1 as per the terms of the contract is arbitrable. Undisputedly arbitrable. I don't dispute that. Claim number 2 and 3 are beyond the scope of arbitration. Now, should I split my claims? Claim number A, I'll go to arbitration. Claim number B and C, I'll go to civil court. Is that so? Or if I bring all the claims together and come to the civil court for adjudication, is the civil court not competent to adjudicate my suit? Can the civil court say, Mr. Ravi, claim number A, I'm deleting from your claim. I'm deleting from your claim. In respect of claim number A, which is the amount due under the contract, you go to arbitration as contemplated under Section 17. And as far as claim number B and C are concerned, I will adjudicate the suit. Can the civil court say that? Or can the civil court assume authority or jurisdiction and say, yes, I will not allow this application under Section 8 because there is no prohibition for the civil court to adjudicate these claims. So, can the civil court or the commercial court for that matter say that I have a jurisdiction to adjudicate all the claims including A, B and C and pass a judgment accordingly? This is my question, and I want all of you to read, make little investigation. It's not a very difficult job. You can do that. Not that I am challenging you, my dear friends. Please don't think otherwise. It's just a very healthy intellectual interaction. All of you may not have a reason. Maybe you did not get a reason to probe into these lines, delve into these lines. And I did have an opportunity recently. Therefore, I want you to check Section 8 and also the authority of the civil court to adjudicate mixed claims. This is a mixed bag, right? My suit or your suit for that matter is consisting of claims which are arbitrable as well as non-arbitrable. In such situation, what is the scope, what is the authority of the civil suit? Let us say this is Friday, so you just probe into the books, probe into the subject, and let's have an interaction. Let's have an answer for this, say by Wednesday, So all the best to you. Let us not waste time. Let us not play puzzles and keep reading forwarding disgusting coronavirus informations, which are generally fake. So let us try to interact intellectually. So my dear friends, check this proposition and then let us come up with an answer. Say by Wednesday coming. See you then. Bye-bye.